Hi, welcome to the very important lecture, which is about typography. Typography is very essential aspect of any good web design. This step should be thought very carefully. By definition, typography is art of designing letter, words, paragraph, and how they interact with each other. It basically refers to the use of fonts for web pages. Typography has a huge impact on multiple aspects of the website, including readability, mood, article length, user experience, and much more. It can literally make or break the final product and can be the difference between being successful or not. It is absolutely essential that designers know and understand the different principles of typography for creating a pleasing design. In my opinion, there are 5 basic principles to be considered while working on typography for a website. Choosing the font is a very important step in a web design process. A web designer must need to carefully choose the right font for a web page. And yes, it takes too much time. There are 2 types of fonts, serif and sans serif. Let us discuss the difference between them. Serif fonts are the ones with the extra bits on the end of the letters. These extra bits are actually called serifs. And sans serif fonts are the ones without the extra bits. I will show you later in this lecture how you can choose some good fonts. If you are a beginner, you should not choose fonts more than 2 for a website. To determine the size of your text, you must consider the purpose. What is it for? Who is its audience? If you want your text to be scanned easily, make it large and less effort for the eyes. I recommend setting text type at 14 to 16 pixels. The third one and very important principle is line height. Basically, line height controls the amount of space between lines of text. If the line height is too tight or too loose, it will create difficulties for user while reading. A good rule of thumb is to set the line height at approximately 150% of text size. For example, if the text size is 14 pixel, then the line height should be 21 pixel, which is about 150 pixel of the text size. Aligning the text properly organizes the content for readers, and it really helps to read the content smoothly. It creates a great visual interest for users when alignment is done very well. And finally, the readability of your content must be considered after applying the best typography. You should sit back and see the readability carefully. Okay, let me show you how you can choose some good fonts online, as I promised in the beginning of this lecture. Google Fonts are the best online resource on the internet. It is very easy to embed Google Fonts in any web project. As you can see, list of free fonts. You can sort it by popularity or by trending. You can filter it for serif or sans serif, like this filter. Let me search for a font, Railway. Add it to collection. You can see style of this font, like normal, italic, medium, semi-bold. It is very easy to add this font to your web project. You have to just copy this link to your head section of your website, and then you have to use the CSS set rule for font family. My second best resource for the fonts is Font Squirrel. You can find free fonts here too. It is also a very great website for providing fonts. Almost free. I have added links to these resources in the resource file, and I recommend you to visit these websites while choosing your fonts. So these 2 are my best resources for fonts. So have a look at them. Now let me show you some amazing tool for choosing a good typography. Golden Ratio Typography Calculator. This is the best one. I mostly use it. Let us experiment with it. If you enter font size of 14, it will give you some good recommendation. You can see recommended line height, content width, and character per length. You can see the live preview here on this page. It is a very amazing tool. You must give it a try while choosing your typography, because it gives you some great measurements for line height, for content width. The second one is Grid Lover. It is also a very great online tool. It makes use of base grid. Do you see this grid? This is called base grid. By using this base grid, you can align your content very beautifully. You can change your font size, you can play around with it, and it will give you some great measurements for your CSS, for your typography, like line height 1.5 em. It gives some great measurements for your headings, for your paragraph, for your user lists, and much more. Here you can see the full preview of your typography. It is a very great tool. You must experiment with it while working on your typography. Okay, well, it was quite a big lecture, and I hope you didn't get bored. See you in next lecture. Thanks.